We will see how to format the chart now. You can see here the x-axis is not highlighted. Okay, let's highlight that one with the bold color. So go to the x-axis and you can click the bold, so it will be bolded now. Suppose if you wanted to highlight with a different color, let's say I'm going to maintain the same color in all the visuals. I will take the same font color. I will maintain all the headers with the 14. So for this one, 14 is too high. Let me reduce 1 point. And the chart title, anyway, we know that these are the countries. Again, we don't need this title, the country. So this is where it we are getting is the field name. You can see the field we have added in the right side, all the fields section. Country field we have added into this chart, right? That's why it is showing again the country. So if you don't need this x-axis title as country, you can turn off here under x-axis, under title, you can turn off this title. The country will be hidden. Actually, you don't need that because all these are countries only. At the same time, in the y-axis, you can turn off this profit. Anyway, we are going to give the title as profit. So now x-axis done, y-axis. I'm open y-axis. You can turn off the title. If you don't need this scale also, you can turn off it. Because already we are showing the values. If at all you don't need that scale, you can turn off. Now we are going to the title. We will go to general section where the title is there. And profit by country, that is the title I want. And you can change the font to Sego EY semi bold, 14 size, bold it. And then centralize the format to the chart object. Earlier it was in the left position. Now it came to the middle position of the chart. If you wanted to give a different color, let's use the same color here. So you can give. At the same time, or else take one lighter color. I will show you why. I will take this lighter color. And even the title background you can give. Title background I will give to this color. So that we will maintain the same thing. Whatever the color you need that is not available here in this color palette, in the themes color or color palette, required color is not available. Select the same shade with a lighter color or a darker color. Select the same shade and go to here, more colors. When you go to the more colors, in the same shaded, you can see various colors. You can move it around. You can see once you leave your mouse, that color will be applied here. Now it is in the dark mode. Then let me move to lighter shade. Now see, lighter color is coming. When you move to the top left corner, the white color will come. So let me move to lighter shade so that some color will be there. So like this, suppose you did not select here with the same shade, with the same shade here. You can directly go to here. You can move this this circle. Again, you can choose whatever the color you need from here. Suppose you need some blue color. You can move here and you can apply that blue color. You can observe the font. It is almost changing to the same color where I my circle is there. So like this, you can apply the colors as well. So let me go back to similar version. Okay. So whatever the recently applied colors will be under this recent colors section. You can directly pick from here if you have applied any recent color that you need again. So like this, you can format the title under effects. You can see the chart background is like this. You can apply for the chart background especially. You can apply some border also for this. See, now the black color border is there. You can go and under the general, under effects, under visual border, you can choose some other color. Let's say some dark color as a border. You can apply the border also like this. Header icons. Header icons we have already discussed under chart like this. If you wanted to format, you can also format header icons here. Let's say the background is this color. Border is some dark color. Icon color some white color. So like this, you can change this icon's color. Now coming to tooltip. Once you hover over your mouse on the chart, you will be able to get some message, the black color, like a country, USA, and the value which is shown on the top. If you would like to format this one also, you can format using the under tooltips. Text, background, you can apply here. But right now I'm leaving with the default colors. I'm not interested. Now coming to the data labels section. Under columns, you can change the color what you want. Like this. Okay, let's go with some lighter shade. Under data labels value section, right now it is with the gray color values. Dark color with the bold. We have already put the display units into none format. Earlier it was a thousands format. I have changed it to none format. That means when you select the thousand format, it will show as a K. When you select millions format, it will show with the millions, 3 million, 3 million, 2 million, like this. When you go to the trillions format, all the values will be shown with the trillion, because these values are not up to 1 trillion. So that is the reason it is showing a 0 trillions. So let's go back with the none format. And if you would like to show decimal places up to 2, you can give 2 as a number here. You can give 2, 4 or 3 or 1. How many decimals you need after the value? You can specify here under the data labels section that many decimals will be shown. So right now I'm going with a 0. For this data labels, if you wanted to give any background, you can give here. So before applying that option, you need to enable this one. Once you enable this, you will be able to get the access to that section. So right now, let's say I'm going with some lighter shade. Let me apply some good color. Now you can see those values surrounded with some shaded. Apply. So like this, you can format. I have covered almost all the formation part for this chart. Like this, format to enhance, to beautify your report. Now I have created a pie chart here and applied the similar format of the bar chart using the format painter. When we are creating a 3 buckets calculated field, we have given underscore 1. If you don't need that underscore 1, but you need that as a field title, if you don't need within the chart, after moving that field to this legend section, double click it and you can rename it. You can remove it. So that underscore 1 is gone on the title. We will create now one more chart. So now I want to see monthly sales. I'm going to take this line chart. Whenever there is a date field in our data, it will be applied as a hierarchy with the 4 hierarchies. One is year, quarter, month, and day. Anyway, we can move this entire date field to here. This is one way. Or else, if you want only the quarter wise, you can move the quarter to here. So now only the quarter will be applied. How many units is sold under each quarter? Turn on the data label. so that I can see the values. Data label is in the thousands format. Display units, let it be none, zero decimals. Suppose when you take any field directly to any chart, sometimes the values will be not formatted as the bar chart shows. In the bar chart, we can see the values or comma separated with zero decimals because we have already formatted. But this unit sold column, we have not yet formatted. Select that unit sold field. As soon as you select, you can see at the top, column tools, one ribbon will open. Under column tools, you just click on this comma. You can move the cursor and see, display the values in this column with commas as a thousand separator. So click on this. You can observe in the bottom, the values are not formatted now. It will be formatted with the commas. You can observe here. With the zero decimals, that's fine. Okay, let me apply the same format to the line chart as well. I just applied all the format. So now it is in the quarter. But I wanted to see month. What should I do? I can remove this quarter. I can move the entire date field with the hierarchy here. And you can go to under date, show as date. Now it is showing as a date hierarchy. Now show as a date. Now it is showing all the dates, all the months. Again, under go to x-axis, these dates will be shown continuous. That means after September, there is no October, but it is showing November, but each 1 month is skipped because it is not fitting into this chart. Under x-axis, go to type and change it to categorical. Now all will be shown. All the dates will be shown here. When you change it to categorical. At the same time, if you look at this field, it is showing with the day, month, year. But if I need only month 3 character and the year with the 2 characters, what should I do? Now we are under this report section. You can see the left 3 icons. So let's go to the data. Here you will be able to see all the data available in the tables. You can see here financial table right now. If at all you have more tables, those tables will be listed down here. Okay, coming to model section. In this model, you will be able to see all the tables. Suppose if you have multiple tables join with each other, you will be able to see the joins here. So maybe in the next class, I will explain you how to use the joins. And under this model section, come to date. Here you can format the dates. So right now the date format is day, month, year, long date. So click on it and you can choose any one date here. Suppose if at all you need any custom format, you can go to the custom. You can select the custom and you can apply the date format. Right now I need my month with 3 characters and year with last 2 characters. Okay, apply it. Just hit enter. It will consider. Now come to the report. See all the dates. September 13, October 13, November 13. Like this, it is applied. Now we have completed how to create a first dashboard. And we will see in the next video how to arrange all these objects in a professional way that looks like a professional dashboard. Please subscribe to my channel Chetana Pixel if you are not done yet. Request your comments on this video. Thank you so much. See you in the next video.